Let's give a warm and elevate Daytona Beach welcome to Monica Vega!
I'm so happy to be here. I was once in that seat that you're in, and I was so excited that everybody was sharing their passions, and I said, yeah, me too. I want to do that too. Maybe that'll inspire you. I moved to this area about a year and a half ago, and I can say all the roles that I play around town, but what matters right now is that I'm your neighbor, and that's how I come. As a neighbor, so take it away, Michael. All right, what if I were to tell you that I can offer you some advice that'll help you save time, money, and give you some peace, and it's free. Do you want it?
Yeah.
I wanted it. So this thing that I've adapted in my life is a lifestyle that has basically changed everything. It's called minimalism. Now you may have heard about minimalism because it's a hot topic lately. Many people are interested in this new trend that helps people change their lives for the better, improve them in every way possible. Now, minimalism requires you to be a loser. Loser always has a bad reputation because losers are incompetent, right? They lose the games, they lose the girl, they lose everything, right? Now, I am super loser to you, and I'm proud of it. I can say that I have lost many things in my life that I did not need, and I feel freer because of it. I've even lost 35 pounds of weight, 300 pounds of clutter, and that's what I'm going to talk to you about. Behind me you will see a picture of my grandfather and myself. My grandfather left Cuba in 1959 when Castro came into power. He lost 3 pharmacies and a wholesale drugstore. He lost his house, he lost everything. He came over to Miami with my family, and in 1979, I was born and became an American citizen. But I very much learned so much from my family because they gave up everything, and they showed me that family was all that mattered. When I was in college, I ended up spending some time in the convent. I almost became a nun. These are simple, loving, beautiful people. I love Jesus, I got to love them. And because of them, I learned the way of minimalism. Mother Teresa, who doesn't know Mother Teresa? The beauty of her giving, right? And she always had the same outfit on. She didn't have many possessions. I wanted to be that. Well, God had different plans for me, and I married a man. I married a man who wanted to become a priest. We fell in love, long story, I'll make that for another day. And then we brought all our stuff together. And I figured out that I had a lot of clutter together with my husband. So what's the first thing I wanted to do? Well, I needed to keep everything, right? Think about your busiest area of your house, the most cluttered area. We do that because we're afraid. It's all fear. Fear of the past, right? Fear of the future. Oh, I might need that one day. So we go to the container store or all these other stores where we get these containers, and I took out my label maker and I labeled everything, and I would spend hours doing that. I can spend time with my husband as much as I spent with these containers. All right? Did you know that we tend to have on average 300,000 items in our households? That's a lot. Then I was introduced to minimalism. The Minimalist, Marie Kondo, and Joshua Becker, these books have taught me so much about minimalism. In other words, no more clutter. Get rid of it. So what I did was, I started emptying my rooms, because that's the first piece of advice that I have for you as well. Take everything out so that you can see the peace. Have you noticed how much we love hotels? Do you feel the freedom that I feel when I walk into a room with only what I need? Okay? You probably feel the same way as well. You feel free. I can go exploring. I can live my life because I don't have to worry about where things go, and I can invite people over because I don't have the fear of hospitality. Now, wardrobe is another thing that I've minimized. You guys know Steve Jobs, and I can throw away many other people in our society who have a uniform. They simplify their closets, and they just wear the same thing. Less decisions, less stress, it's great. But what do you do with all the things? Where do you throw them? Not in the trash. There's so many thrift stores that will accept your possessions. I love the Light New Shop of Prince of Peace in Ormond Beach. They take our possessions, and they sell them, and they give them back to the community in the food pantry. All of this freed me up. I give gifts to my children now that are experiences. My daughter wanted horseback riding lessons. I didn't need to buy her a plastic horse, neither do you, okay? Now, what time do you free up to do when you don't have things to fix up in your house and declutter? You have time to do fishing and gardening and stargazing, everything behind me, and insert here the thing you most like to do. Maybe it's travel, but I don't have time for that. For me, it's being able to dance some salsa because I love my salsa, okay? So it gives me time in my schedule. I have less cleaning to do. I worry that my three children will one day see me and think of the cleaning mom, right? Picture mom, she's cleaning, she's organizing. I don't want that. I don't think you'd want that for your children, grandchildren, or family members to remember you by. I want them to remember the silly mom who had experiences with them. Those are the things that matter in your life, not your possessions, okay? So we should be super losers. And as a student of mine, Bella, just told me today, when two losers or more get together in two, we are winners.
Aha. So let's be ready. Daytona is an amazing place to live, and Elevate Daytona just elevates us all as a community. It was so great. Thanks, Daytona.